cooked. I'm so excited. I'm so hungry.
We got a mortgage.
Right. Because I can say this child is mine since it came out of my vagina. You want to play like that?
Look at these kids.
I will never say how much money Michael has. I will say that I think that he does well.
And how much money
would you need? Get off the top of that, baby. You saw that?
I can't.
I hope you can hear this. I think I have my earbuds in, but I went to the leasing office just a second ago. I finished my leg workout. I was like, let me just go to the leasing office and say something about the dog, because in workout, this thing I'll be like, what the hell is in that? End workout. Sorry, I almost. Start indoor walk. Okay. So I talked to the guy in the leasing office, and he was like, I was like, did anybody else say something last night about the dog that howled from like 1 to 3 a.m.? And he was like, yeah, that he also heard the dog and was up. Y'all, it sounded like a pure wolf, like all night long, like all night. And I just wanted to get a little dog a hug, baby, because he just wanted somebody to be home and nobody was there. But anyway, he said it's going to be addressed, because I was like, I'm about to go buy some earplugs, which I still am about to buy some earplugs, because the neighbor above me, just the time he gets off work is the time that I'm like going into that REM sleep, and I need that deep sleep before I start stirring around later. So we still don't get some earplugs, but I'm just glad it just wasn't me. I'm not a complainer, and I know you live in an apartment, you're gonna hear noise, but that was beyond last night. Earplugs today, y'all. Let me get to reading. So there was a shit job.
How you doing? You on the path for the rest of the year?
Well, that's what she called. Tell me she's in the
bed. He just mislooked at it. Like this.
I'm just gonna have her to braid it.
Yeah, individuals be too much for my size too.
Mm-hmm. 2 weeks, so bad.
Are you going out of town or something? You just don't want it to look old and fine. Mm-hmm.
And then I don't want to have to sit there all the damn time.
Yeah.
Because at first, I told her.
That was my whole reason. I don't like to tip.
Because how long does it take to do those? It shouldn't take it.
Mm-hmm. About like, because it's still individuals, like, you know, depending on what size you get, it's still like about 4 hours.
Okay, see, it took 6 hours.
Okay, so yeah.
I told her next time we should go bigger. When she started, with 3 at the bottom, 3, 4, 5, she's going up. I told her to start 4, 5. That way they're bigger. And then when I started thinking about it, yeah, they're bigger. And then they're up here. That's still going to be bigger. Still going to be too heavy.
It got to be a fix for that. The hair. Y'all, today.
Okay, look, for a second, I was like, barbershop. And then I saw in the walls, I was like,
to. I need to take a nap. I swear.
Oh, you want it before then?
Well,
we can get it before. I'm not in a hurry to do anything. There's no other
one. Let's get the dog.
Y'all, I'm back at the city. Cheers. We got the dogs on the patio. It's real, real city girl stuff.
With Louie. You like Louie tough? Yeah, my baby, he's blind. Say hello, Tub. Say hey, Tub. I'm Louie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, you're so sweet.
But, Tub, there's Louie.
And he's good, big fan. Guys, this is my favoriteest friend in the whole wide world. Y'all already know my little booby. That's my friend. So we're having a Tavala meal tonight. And I chose beef chili and cornbread. And I probably should have it right now because it's 6:37. Even though I'll be trying to wait to eat, I need to eat right now. I already know.
We'll put it this way. If you want me to cook it and then you just take it home with you, that's fine. Because trust me, all you got to do is pop it in the microwave. The cornbread will already be done. Because when I cook that, both of them go in this oven. And it cooks all at the same time. It's funky.
Oh, let's see what it looks like. So this is Tavala. The my girl milk, has the convection oven.
The cornbread, cheese.
Oh, and I didn't know it was that involved.
I don't put the cheese.
Oh, you have to make the cornbread?
Yeah. And you put it all in the oven at the same time. So you put the cornbread mix in there.
So here
we're going to make it.
Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. I'll probably eat it right after you warm it up anyway. I'm interested in this. I cannot.
So I don't put the cheese in the chili. I put the cheese inside of the bread.
All right. I'm with it. I'm going to take your advice. Okay. So we're making a quick cornbread. It's like Jiffy.
That's exactly what it tastes like too.
It's a Jiffy cornbread. Oh, what's that? Like,
this is the egg, whatever you would put in Jiffy.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But then I also have to do water.
Oh, I'm so interested.
Which I probably shouldn't be using this. Now I should probably use something else because it's whipping it and it's like with the milk and the eggs and stuff, so it's giving it a thicker batter, but I wanted to make sure it's all mixed together.
Yeah, like mixed
these
up.
These are all clean,
right?
So,
it is. I can't. I will unload it.
We have been to pins forever.
Yum with the butter. Louie, what you doing, Louie?
Baby, will you pass me a fork? Louie, daddy's not in there, baby. Louie. You're not getting none of this.
He likes to watch, though. He definitely watched me cook.
This is the cheese.
Oh, so it's like a cheesy cornbread?
Well, no, the cheese actually goes in the
chili.
The cheese
tastes better on the cornbread.
I like to put it in the cornbread. The chili is the ground beef and everything. It's already pre-seasoned. Look. But you already know black folks gotta put their extra in it.
Y'all want some cheesy cornbread and some. Ooh, that's gonna be so good. I'm excited.
We're all the family dinners are better. My family
fan,
I
don't know how old
it is, pretty good.
The
first one
better.
So
we're
going to
add a little garlic.
But ours is pretty, my family's pretty.
Add a little garlic powder to it.
Right. But what's the difference, Dave? The seasoning?
Well, I don't know, probably maybe some, I don't know, some of the food options, but one of my favorite dishes is when he has that
one. Okay, so we're putting
it's
that.
Like dressing, it's not dry. Like some dressing can be dry. My family recipe for dressing.
It'll be done in 20 minutes.
Oh my god. It's like your own personal little mini cornbread.
Yes.
Oh my god. I'm like,
about and then all you gotta do is transfer it to a plate. Hold on, let me cut this. All you had to do is transfer it to
a plate.
Oh my
god. Eat some of that. Okay, Dave, have so much fun. Bye. Good seeing you always. Oh my god. I'm so hungry.
So I can put.
I really haven't been in my video. This is one of my favorite places to be. Always. Felicia always takes care of me. It's like one of my best friends, y'all. I'm gonna tear this food up. Y'all don't even know. Like, that's my best friend, pool bestie, that y'all saw earlier in the summer. We about to chill. I just looked up my girl's birth chart, her and her man's. Like, I'm about to explain to them what they got going on. My girl lives in this beautiful condo and I don't get to come over here as much as I love, but I'm here now. Me and Tuff following me around. Look, it is Friday. Somehow it's Friday. It's October 27th. I just got myself up, packed, and ready to do a few things before I head to Memphis. I'm getting ready to drive. It's like 11:30. I said I wanted to be gone by like noonish. It's probably not gonna happen now, but whatever. I literally have no plans today, so I'm just cruising. Like, sometimes I just need to do that, like, to intentionally go slower. So I just packed, I just put my stuff in the car. I'm going to go ahead and get my shoes on and stuff, so I need to drop something off at the shop today, which one of the girls said we needed like some little soap or whatever. So I'm about to run to the store, grab that, get some gas. A friend of mine sent me some lunch money, but I did not eat the lunch yesterday because, buddy, you saw Wednesday. So we're going to use that to get us a little snack on the road or whatever. Let's go to the podcast. We'll be on. My camera is still dirty. I don't know. Anyway, I made it to Memphis. Yay. Going to my mom's house. All her sisters and her brothers are there. Not all of them, but most of them. And yeah, and then I'm gonna stay at my sister's house by because she got the room. I'm not staying at this house without my mom's sisters and brothers, but anyway, I'm about to go up there. I made it, say. I know y'all remember this word from the Memphis vlog. But I'm home. It is warm and my mama has spiked it with. She's the only person that lives here, so what am I telling her? She don't have to turn her around for me. But I wait. My sister has a meeting at her house at 6:30, so I'm waiting for her to get done with her meeting. And then I'm gonna go over there after that, and we're gonna have some wings or something. Y'all miss my uncles and aunts. They went to one of my uncles went to his daughter's house. She was cooking. So, should I get my mom talking about something? Get off here.
Got some chicken wings. Ooh, it can work. Hold on.
Y'all, I was so tired yesterday, and yet and still, here I am. Let's play this out. Oh, perfect. Awake. Today is the memorial service. It's not till 3 o'clock, so I just decided to get up because Wednesday I did not start editing this vlog, so I'm going to start doing that today. So Sunday when I get back, I'll just have a little bit to do so I can get the vlog out. So that's what I'm doing. It's quiet at my sister's house. Nothing going on. So y'all know I'm just watching my Dateline, and I'll get up and get something, a bite to eat or something in a minute. But what y'all doing? Y'all doing something fun for Halloween? I'm a little jelly. Just a little. But anyway, let me get to it. Y'all, I'm about to be up in this chair as soon as I give me something to eat. Okay. My sister has such a cute gal room. This is her money tree. Lord. Okay. This thing with this one, this part over that right there squeezes you. I really like that a lot. It's a perfect fall day in Mississippi. How cute. I'm on the road. not really though. I'm actually on my way to my mom's to pick up some camera equipment that just yesterday she told me she was not going to give me. Like, she did not feel like going through it. But
my dad had a lot of cameras. He used to take pictures all the time and video of us, and like I would love to have that equipment and like tinker around and play with it. So I'm on my way to pick that up, and then I'm on my way to Nashville. Baby, it's early, and I'm like, it's early enough where I can like get home, start editing this vlog, finishing the vlog, and then having it be ready to like pop out tomorrow. I'm excited about that. Like, I do not like driving, which I was talking about this yesterday with people. People do not understand it, but I don't care for it. I'd rather have somebody else do it. Once I get on the road, I love it. It's so quiet. It's so chill. It's just not a lot going on. I can listen to the stuff I've been wanting to listen to. And kind of get out of my head for just a little while. I'll probably formally close this out when I get home, but I like it. Like, I'm on the freeway, like, now, like, on my way from Mississippi to Memphis, and I like it. Anyway, I ramble a lot. I've been rambling hella in this vlog, so I'm gonna try to not do that. Bye. Y'all, I tried to stop for food. I am so easily grossed out. Like, I stopped. I was like, oh, okay, I can eat like a Mexican pizza or something from Taco Bell. And then I see the dude coming in. He got his gloves on. Why do you need to wear your gloves outside? Like, you could have pulled them off to go outside. Like, so I don't trust people enough to know that you're gonna go in there and take the gloves off. So skip that. Then I went to McDonald's and I was just like, I really just don't want McDonald's. So I drove off and I was like, you know, I'll find a Subway. And then the lady at the Subway was coming out of the bathroom with her gloves on. So I'm like, she was like, you go to the bathroom? And she was like, don't use this stall. And I'm like, I go in there and I'm like, first of all, I'm not gonna use none of these stalls because I'm grossed out. Like, it's water on the floor. I need to get out of here because it's water from the toilets on the floor. Gross. So now I don't even want the Subway because you just came out of there and you had on your gloves too. You know what? We just gonna wait. I'm like, I'm not gonna eat nowhere on this exit. I'm out of here. I'm still hungry. Now I'm hungry. But I could not. I just feel like you should take your gloves off if you go outside or smoke a cigarette or go to the bathroom. What is the logic? Are you going to remove them and put on a new pair? You're touching other stuff, so that means you wash your motherfucking hands. I'm grossed out. Bye. That's all. That's what happened to me.
If you're listening to this, you probably already know what I'm about to say, but today is the day for you to start your podcast. You have everything that you need.
I'm listening to Sisters Who Kill right now. But also, I went to another Subway off a real cute exit, okay? That exit was given. I don't want nobody making my food on this exit. And the dude had an attitude who made this sandwich, but you know what I did? I prayed over it and I asked God to help him with whatever he was going through in his life. That made him have an attitude because I said, don't the cheese. I ordered a sandwich, a specific sandwich. And it comes with the cheese on it. And he's asking me what kind of cheese. I'm like, the one that's supposed to be on it. You got an attitude, baby. Just put some provolone on it and keep the attitude. And I continue to be my chipper self because you're not about to ruin my mood. But I pray for him. I'm going to get out of here. No more until I get home because I most certainly need to concentrate on driving. Because people are going to start looking for me here real soon. I spent too long trying to get food. Bye-bye, y'all.